Beholding your beauty is all that I long for. To worship you, Jesus, is my sole desire. For this very heart you have shaped for your pleasure. Surrender in pure adoration. I enter your courts with an offering of praise. I am your servant, come to bring you glory, as it's fit for the work of your hands. Now unto the Lamb who sits on the throne.
Genesis 14. Chapter 14, when we go home, let's go and read it so that we can understand it better. So we all know about the Isaac issue with Abraham. And then he did something else again. And that's exactly what we are learning today. Division 1 of the lesson says, Abraham gave his tithe. This is another way, another time Abraham appreciated God. He rated him as number one, so he did not withdrew anything from God. And that is how we are learning, that we should not withdraw anything from God. We should not count anything to be too much to give. We should not say, oh, I can give this, I can give that, but when it comes to this, please count me out. I'm not ready. So if we rate God as who God is, we will not say that. Amen. Amen. He says here, he says, he gave his tithe. And on page 20, if you have the copy of the book with you, page 20, division says, Abraham had gone to war to bring back his captured nephew. That's what I said. When we read it, we understand it better. It is in Genesis 14. Lot was captured, but Abraham went to the war and brought him back. He says, Abraham had gone to war to bring back his captured nephew, Lot, with his possessions. God gave him the much needed victory with the attendant loot. Most challenging is the fact that on Abraham's return, he refused to be selfish with the proceeds. He went to war to bring Lot, his nephew, who was captured. So he brought all his possessions with him. And then when he came back, he did something very wonderful to God. He did something very great to God. And what did he do? He brought his tithe. He brought his tithe to Melchizedek, the priest. He says that instead, he chose to give God the glory of the exploits, release the proceeds to his co-fighters, and give the tithe of the proceeds to God. We will be learning from him. We are learning from Abraham. After being victorious, he brought his tithe to God. Well, we can have said before somebody and say, you answer this question. So let us all follow. Amen.
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 Amen. So he says here, he said he gave his tithe. That is 14:1 following. He got victory from God. Abraham got victory from God. He understands that God was the source of his victory. So who is the source of your victory? Ask your neighbor, who is the source of your victory? Ask your neighbor, who is the source of your victory? And what is the response? God. God is the source of our victory. And that is what exactly Abraham acknowledged. And that is why he paid his tithe. That's what I've just said, that when we do things to God, it's not as if we are bribing him. We are showing our appreciation. Amen.
Amen.
And even like a man to son, when you do something to your dad, or to your son, when he appreciates, you do more. That's how it works. Amen.
Amen.
And blessed be, he says in the where we have in Genesis chapter 14, he says, and blessed be God Most High, who delivered your enemies into your hand. There was a serious situation on ground. Lot and his possession had been captured by the ravaging enemies. And as soon as the news got to Abraham, he mobilized the 318 trained men in his household to pursue the looters, instead of ignoring that of Abraham. So that's why I sang the song before I started. We all sang that song. We all want the blessings of Abraham. Are we like Abraham? Is our heart like Abraham? We need to have the heart of Abraham so that we do not withdraw anything from God. We do not count anything as being too big to give to God. Amen.
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 Knowing fully well that the Lord is the source of all riches. Amen. He's the source of all riches. The wisdom you are using in your place of work, the favor that was on you for you to have been able to get the job, is all from God. Amen.
Amen.
And for you even to do the work nicely, and your boss always appreciates you, oh, you are so good. Oh, you are wonderful. Oh, it's only that I can do it better. All is from God. And we should always return the appreciation to him. We should always return all the gratitude to him. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And he's the source of even the good health you are using there. Without sound health, you cannot be there. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we should always appreciate him at all times. Acknowledge him at all times as the source of all our victory, the source of all our richness, our riches, the source of everything. That is our God. And that is who, and that is who, and that's how we should rate our God as number one. Amen. So we should all rate him as number one. And as we continue to do so, God will bless us in Jesus' name. Amen. Isaac, he appreciated God the giver. Abraham appreciated God the giver. Then Abraham gave him a tenth of everything. He said he gave tenth of everything. Amen. The grace to do this, God will give unto us in Jesus' name. Like we said last week, if you are doing two jobs, three jobs, just say, oh, this is my main income. I can only give God from this one. What about the other one you are keeping? Are you the source of it? No, you are not. It's God. Amen. So we should not withhold anything from him. Said Abraham gave the tenth of everything. Tell your neighbor, everything.
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 Amen. So whether your second job or your third job or your fourth job, give everything to God. Amen. One tenth of everything. He says here. It seems to suggest that Abraham turned his attention away from the king Sodom, who had come out to meet him earlier, until he was through with worship of the true God. In other words, he offered to God the recognition, honor, and honor that is due to him. He recognized God and gave him the honor that is due to him. No wonder he wasn't going to allow anybody except God to receive the glory of his life. So we should all give all glory to God. The glory is not even to you. It's not to you to say, oh, because I can do it. If you see, I'm so smart, I can do it. Before you know it, I've done it. Before you know that everything is completed, it is not you. It is God. So God should always have all the glory. As Abraham gave the title to Melchizedek, he didn't know he was giving to the Prince of Peace to come. Just be willingly faithful to tithing and giving offering. You don't know when the bounteous harvest will come. Amen. So God is the one that will reward you. So while you are paying your tithe, you are giving offering, God is the one that will reward you. Amen. He says, why should it be difficult for you to give God the tithe of your proceeds as well as other specific offering and donations, even as we share those blessings with others? If you really appreciate the fact that he saved you and is giving your life meaning. So he says we should not find it difficult when we know that God is the source of all and is the one that has given our life meaning. He has given you meaningful life. You are not just living just for the fun of it. Amen. You can see all of us in our nice attire, well fitting. Amen. It is God. Amen. Tell your neighbor, it is God.
It is God.
So we should always appreciate him at all times and give what is due unto him. So we should not withdraw anything from him. Lessons derived. Recognize God as the source of the victories and successes in your life. And you are in for more victorious and success-packed experiences. He says when you appreciate him, then you are in for more. You are in for what? You are in for more when you appreciate him. Amen. May we not labor in vain in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The second lesson from the lesson says, what we're learning from this lesson, it says appreciation of God's faithfulness should be in both cash and kind. It says it should be in both cash and kind. Amen. And it says, learn from Abraham. We need to learn from Abraham. Amen. Amen. So we've come to the end of the lesson. We've come to the end of the lesson. You can quickly tell us what we've been talking about. Amen? I'm going to pinpoint somebody to tell us what we've been learning about, what we've been talking about. I've told us that we should listen. Amen? Can somebody help us out before I point my finger to somebody? Before I ask one of our mommies and our daddies and our sisters, and what have we been talking about? Amen? Somebody help. Thank you. God bless you, sister. Appreciating God. Say that again.
Appreciating God through our giving.
through our giving. Amen. Appreciating God through our giving. Amen. 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 Somebody else want to say something? I know we are not just sitting down. We are learning. Amen. And I've said it that we might have learned it before, but the word of God is always anew. Amen. And you might have heard it before, and it doesn't really make any difference. But today, God will let it make a difference in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Somebody, I need another contributor, please. Through our worship to God. Thank you, God bless you, man. Through our worship to God. He says it has to be in kind and cash. It has to be in kind and cash. So we should not just say, oh, they want money. I'll give them money. So once I've given them money, and not with the right attitude. It has to be with the right attitude. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Tolu, God bless you. Yes.
Showing your unconditional love.
So showing your unconditional love. Thank you. Bless you. God bless you. Sisters have been talking. Sisters. Mommies. One contribution from one of our male learners. Somebody do. One of brothers. Amen.
Amen.
Abraham, when God said, oh, offer Isaac as a sacrifice, he didn't query God. He didn't question God, and he gave it to God. And God, what? God gave him back many things. So, and with that, I believe that we should be able to learn from this. Sunday school today is a very good topic, and we believe that, we have a lot of people here, we should be able to imbibe the spirit of what? Of giving to God. And God will bless us as we listen.
Amen. Thank you. God bless you, sir. I've told you, our brothers and our daddies, they are loaded. Amen.
Amen.
Let us stand up for prayers, please. Let us have our prayers. I know we've all learned one thing of brother. Amen. And the grace to do God will give unto us in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, eternal of God, this will bless your holy name. We give you all glory, give you all adoration, because you are worthy of them all. Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this grace you've given to us to learn at your feet this morning. Father, Lord, the grace, O Lord, to be the hearer and the doer of the word given to us in Jesus' name. Amen. All these lessons we are let them not stand against us on judgment day in Jesus' name. Amen. We commit the rest of the program into your hand, Father, take absolute control in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And at the end of the program, let us go home blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And all glory will be yours in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen,
amen, amen, amen. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Bible says, in the presence of God,